All right, what do we got here? This hand's a little sketchier. It's got a probe. So I'm going to be able to draw cards and then snapcast or draw cards. I'm going to try it. Maybe this hand's too sketchy, but seems like it's got potential. Potential to go horribly, horribly wrong. All right, what did my opponent draw? Yeah, Spellsnare's bad. Spell Scout, Wall of Roots, Pod, Cord, Ranger. Alrighty. I'm going to pay the life because whatever my opponent plays, I'm just going to go ahead and Vapor Snag end of turn. Since I'm hoping to draw lands afterwards. I mean, if I draw a second... The reason I kept this is if I draw a second land, I can Snapcast or Probe, or I can just cast Remand, and both of them get me to a third land a lot of the time. At least give me a good shot. Alright. And this will be a Wall of Roots. And... Let's just go ahead and Vapor Snag that. Blood Moon looks like it's going to be pretty nice if I can ever resolve it this game. Ooh, land is nice. Just pass, I've got Remand ready. Opponent also had... opponent had two lands, I had one. But, you know, I was lucky enough to hit here. And opponent not doing much else. Let's see, so what do I want to play now? I could Snapcaster for double draw here, but I think I'm going to play Young Pyromancer and then... Cast Gitaxian Probe and get a token and hope to draw an extra land here. Opponent has Pontiff. Ooh, that's an unwelcome addition. Alright, so I'm going to get Pontiff next turn, which is unfortunate, but not the end of the world. And leaves my opponent with Spellskite, Wall of Roots, Pod, Cord, Ranger. Draw. Alright, did not hit a land. And if I don't hit an island, then I don't really want to cast Blood Moon either. Opponent not playing around Blood Moon, which is nice. So if my opponent doesn't draw a land here, we'll just cast Pontiff. If my opponent did draw land, I'd get to cast Wall of Roots into Pontiff, and that would have been a lot worse for me. Land? Alright, so now I can cast Blood Moon, but my opponent gets to play Birthing Pod. And can Birthing Pod a Pontiff into something? Let's just play Sulphur Falls, and I guess I Snapcast her. The Gitaxian Probe? Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, let's get a Gitaxian Probe. I know what my opponent's got, so it's not too much of a surprise. Basically, I don't need to cast Blood Moon this turn. I can develop my board a little bit first, draw some extra cards. So, two cords. So, next turn. And then, if my opponent draws a land, it's pretty sucky for me. But if my opponent doesn't draw a land, I'd rather have Grim out than Delver. No land. Because if my opponent draws a land, Birthing Potting away Pontiff into a red cap is just a beating. But, and you can haunt one of my creatures and get the other one. But if my opponent doesn't draw a land, Wall of Roots into Spellskite is okay. And then I get to do some things. Alright, let's take my one. Draw another Grim Lavamancer. So I can bolt. I can kill the Wall of Roots and I can like Vapor Snag the Spellskite, or I suppose not in that order. Well, let's attack with Snapcaster Mage first, see what my opponent does. I doubt my opponent's going to block with a Grim Lavamancer in play here. But you never know. Oh, wow. Okay, well that makes things a little better for me, since now I can Vapor Snag the Spellskite and Grim the Wall of Roots here. That was not a not greedy block. So, and then it's Grim the Wall of Roots, exiling Pyromancer and I guess Vapor Snag. And then just pass the turn. The reason I'm passing the turn now is if my opponent does draw a land, I want to be able to bolt Pontiff in response to Birthing Pod. If my opponent doesn't draw a land, I would have rather have played a Delver or a Grim Lavamancer, but I think this is a little bit safer. I don't want to get my board completely wrecked. The problem is if I play another one toughness creature, my opponent plays Pod, sacks Pontiff, haunts my Snapcaster or whatever, and then gets a red cap and kills it, that's a lot worse for me. So, Spellskite, which I can still kill if I want to. Let's bolt the Pontiff in response, I think. I'm just running so short on mana here that I think I need to use it all as much as possible. Alright, opponent passes. Alright, let's probe, though. I think I know what's going on mostly. Ooh, a red cap in hand. Okay, and a choke. Choke's annoying. But I drew a mana leak, which was an insane draw, since now I get to attack for two, play another Lavamancer or a Delver. Which one would I rather have in play? Opponent's on 14. I think I'd rather just have a Delver in play. And then now I get to mana leak whatever my opponent plays this turn. And then at some point I can play Blood Moon. Of course, my opponent drew Basic Forest, but that's okay. So I'm going to mana leak Red Cap here, which is nice too because Red Cap can get cast through Blood Moon. So don't have to worry about that at least. And hoping to flip here. That would be nice. And all right, well, I drew a Basic Island instead, which is also decent. So let's go ahead and attack. I'm just going to attack with everything because I'm going to Snapcaster Mana Leak here. Whatever my opponent plays next. And just pass the turn. I mean, I could Blood Moon, but I really want to get this Birthing Pod countered. And if it's just a Ranger, I'd rather just, I mean, I'm fine Snapcaster Mana Leak in the Ranger too. Just puts more things on the board. Do have to worry about this Lavamancer dying to Pontiff, so Pontiff Haunt doesn't happen. Opponent could pass with a Cord for two up, which would be a lot worse for me, but yeah, I don't think that's as likely. Snapcaster Mage. Target Mana Leak. Actually, I should have remanded that. That was actually bad. I think I actually want Ranger in my opponent's hand. And then I would have been able to flip Delver, I'm sure. Let's attack with everything but the Lavamancer. Since Lava Man is ready to fire off. Alright, land. Blood Moon, which severely impacts what my opponent can play. And I guess I just pass. I don't need to play the second Lavamancer, and if my opponent has a way to kill this Grim Lavamancer, then I am in real big trouble. So, and if my opponent doesn't, I think my opponent is fairly dead. So I think this works out for the best. So what can my opponent play here? It's gonna get Spellscatter down to, or Lavamancer down to six. Next turn I attack, block Snapcaster, so you can get. The problem is you can play Birthing Pod, but it doesn't really accomplish much. All right, do I want to kill the bird? No, I think I just kill my opponent. Leaving Vapor Snag and Bolt in the graveyard since those will do the trick. All right, well, bad Delver. And let's attack. See what my opponent does here. I suppose this didn't work out quite as well as I would have liked. Maybe I should have played the second Lavamancer. Let's see, so what can my opponent do? Cast, again, can cast something off birds, but I can put my opponent to one, but that doesn't really do much for me, so let's just pass the turn. Leave Lavamancer up still. And what can you do? You can cast a Court of Calling. Uh-oh, is this a red cap? This looks like a top deck red cap. Or potentially a Birthing Pod. It is a red cap. Alright. So I guess now I'm in trouble. I mean, if I draw a burn spell, I might be able to win. But if I do not. Yeah, I should have just played this other Lavamancer. I guess I was enough dead that it didn't actually matter. Alright. And I guess with my opponent now gonna be at one Spellskite, it's a little harder to run, but alright. Let's draw. And I get out of it in the best way possible, which is Vapor Snagging the Spellskite. Alright, that was ugly, but we got there. And it wasn't a whole lot else that could have helped. My opponent was gonna get a Birthing Pod out, but hey, I guess I'll take it.